Dobro jutro.
Dobro jutro.
Ja sam Dinda Busija. So, today we will take a walk, sort of a memory down the memory lane, and also I think it's going to be a walk that will give you a better understanding of what Pristina is, and also where does the art scene and artists from Pristina come from, in the sense of sort of space and culture and sort of placement and embodiment of their work. My narrative today is not going to be as I planned exactly, because we're just going to go to places that are near and more convenient, but I will tell you historically where the narrative fits and how we will go about it. So we are in the part of Pristina today that is more sort of older part of Pristina, in the street over there. You have a lot of mosques, and you have mosques dating from 15th century and onwards and things like that. You have a church up there. So the city was actually built down the stream of the river that was going. I think the river was there. It doesn't exist anymore. So this is how the city was formed. Well, Pristina was not a capital of Kosovo until the 1946. So it was a small sort of place with not a very particular history. The history of Pristina started developing especially around the 50s. And you can see new buildings, and the buildings that you see around, apart, so you have the museum here, that is late 19th century, this house here. You know, I think that the slogan that existed in Pristina in the 50s, there was this famous slogan, let's destroy the past and build the new, the sort of socialist slogan. It kind of stuck with Pristina throughout the years. It's still that, the same mentality of sort of destroy the past and build the new. And unfortunately, a lot of Pristina and a lot of places, even from people like my generation, and I'm going to be 40 soon, so even for us, you know, the memories are changing, the spaces are not there. So I'm just trying to tell you, you know, a little bit of Pristina. To be a puppet theater, and then it became the center of art and theater in Kosovo during the 90s. So he had a lot of performance during the 90s, and the theater suddenly became very important. Everybody was going to the theater. And maybe what you see in Pristina very often is that the spaces are, you know, the modest spaces like this, and we will see many examples during our walk together. If you have any good legacy of 1990s, were actually the legacies of creating this alternative spaces for art.
The salsa and the banana, we know we had it 3 years ago with Manny Katayati. You remember when
you
did
the...
Yes, when it was done by Boris Bakal. When it was
six years ago.
Rent the space to use for the purposes. This was...
1992.
Yeah. No, from 94.
94.
Yeah. From 94, they have from theater activities and for the gallery and for cultural activities, some funds that not so big.
It's actually even the sign of sort of that's destroy the old and rebuild the new, and this is a sort of a big socialist project of making a Pristina capital of Kosovo. The thing is that people felt, according to Eliza Hoxha, felt very monitored. So you had the parliament, and you had the municipality, and this was supposed to be a sort of a place for citizens to stay and walk and just come together. And it never really became, you know, it became, this was important because it was in the old postcards, but the space was never really used for, you know, as a public square as it was imagined.
Thank you.
full of gold. Just a little spoon of your precious love satisfy my soul. A man lies about a little. Some of them cry.
I think that this building, this burnt house that was burned during the NATO bombing by Serbian police, is actually one of the way to tell the story about the 1990s. The 1990s were very confusing, but with Milosevic coming to power in 87, by 88, he wanted to do this sort of centralization of Yugoslavia, and he had all this plan of de-bureaucratization of Yugoslavia and re-centralization. Take the power from two leaders, then Katyusha Yashari, woman, and Azem Vlasi.
Uhapsite Vlasia.
It's a sort of an abandoned place. It was again sort of appropriated. There is an exhibition there of two young artists in the afternoon. Different spaces like this all around Pristina. It's really abandoned. The houses, or old houses like that, with a cheap rent. The ambition is have a space have fun and create together in spaces like this.
It could be. Just a little spoon of your precious love.